What's going on, you guys? My name is Matt, and I am with the 2020 Mercedes-Benz GLE. This is the second generation GLE, but this is not the second time that Mercedes have brought us a mid-size SUV. Before the GLE, we had the lovely ML. Everyone loved it, it was fantastic. But now we have this actually really, really nice new GLE. This GLE is Mercedes' answer to the BMW X5 and the Audi Q5. It's their mid-size SUV, and this is the first time that you'll be able to option a third row in it. Aside from that, of course, like I said, this is an all-new generation for the GLE. It's a completely new look, and it's a little bit different than what we've seen in the past. It's a little bit more sculpted, it's a little bit smoother, but it still maintains a nice muscular look with a higher ride height, more ground clearance, and this beefy bumper with this chrome plating on it. The profile is very reminiscent of the outgoing GLE. We have a classic SUV shape. There's not a whole lot of tapering in the back. You get a little bit of slant back here in the window, but you still have a lot of space for cargo and headroom in the rear seat. This actually is stretched another 2 inches from the outgoing GLE, so it is going to be a lot bigger, but it doesn't completely lose its roots. We still have the classic GLE larger C-pillar. Now, like I said, this new GLE is a little bit more muscular. It's a little bit more tuned to remind you that it's capable of going off-road. You have these nice runner panels here because, like I said, this is a higher ground clearance. And you have the smaller contrasted black 18-inch painted wheels because you have a nice sidewall for rock crawling, sand, mud, anything that you can get your GLE into, and maybe some snow later. And then of course, as we get to the back of the vehicle, we see that the kind of contemporary yet elegant design is maintained. Of course, you have a nice back windscreen here. It's very easy to see out of. You have a nice windshield wiper back there as well. But the nice thing about these taillights is they're LED standard and they look really cool. They add a nice little flair to the design, a little bit of character. And then as we move down, we see that the bumper is nice and muscular. You have dual exhaust, as you would expect, and we have a chrome trimming to make it look a little bit more muscular. And then, of course, getting into the trunk, it's as simple as pushing a button on the rear hatch, pushing a button on your key, or some trims will come available with kick gesture trunk release, which is fantastic, and I highly recommend you go for it. However, once you get inside, you see that the trunk space is massive. You have just exorbitant amounts of space back here. Of course, you have tether points around the floor of your car, and you also have a 12-volt socket in here and various laundry hooks. If you want more storage, you obviously have a little bit extra storage along the side of your full-size spare tire under your trunk floor. So with that, let's check out the back seats. Now that we're seated in the back seat, you can just see how palatial this is. I mean, I have so much headroom. I have like 4 inches of headroom. I've got like a foot of knee room, which is just ridiculous. Dual AC vents, a cubby, USB-C charger, and another normal house outlet. It's just unending sort of practicalities and functionalities back here. Plus, you also have anchors if you want to attach a rear seat entertainment package on your own. And the seats, like I said, of course, split, and you have dual cup holders right here. What else do you want? Now that we're up front, this is where all the action is. And like I mentioned before, this is a new generation, this is a new design, and this is where you can really tell they spent a lot of money and where you're gonna get your money to go the furthest for you. This is the brand new kind of face cockpit of the Mercedes GLE. It's the new MBUX infotainment system, 12.3 inch screen, voice commands, touch sensitive steering wheel, touchpad right here, of course, got haptic feedback. If you want the full in-depth analysis of my MBUX, it's in our A-Class video on our Facebook page, so go check that out. However, some of the highlights are, like I said, artificial intelligence, augmented reality in the nav screen. You'll also be able to have much more conversations with your car. Hey, Mercedes, I'm hungry. Hey, Mercedes, I'm cold. Hey, Mercedes, I want the ambient light to be chartreuse. You can do things like that. And you can also do things as simple as, hey, Mercedes, tell me a joke. It really is super cool. And if you don't have many friends, it's a nice companion. But overall, the interior is gorgeous. They nailed the design. There's ambient light everywhere. It's so impressive looking at night. But even during the day, you've got your nice string of pearls vents. Of course, it's, you know, more rectangular, more muscular, more rugged looking for this off-road capable SUV. And you have these new grab handles, which I wasn't sure how I felt about at first, but they actually are fantastic. I find myself putting my hand right here all the time when I'm driving. And it just kind of reminds you that you're in something that now has the capability to go anywhere in the world. And we haven't even talked about materials yet, and it's a Mercedes, and I know I say it every video, but leather's great, wood's great, contrasted brushed aluminum, fantastic. overall, the ergonomics of the cabin are just wonderful. It's super, super comfortable. I absolutely love it. But enough talking about the interior. Let's get this thing on the road and see what it can do. All right, we are behind the wheel of the new 2020 GLE. And since this is Milwaukee and Wisconsin, you have a lovely blizzard going on today, April 10th. Yes, April 10th. Last year there was a blizzard on April 6th, so don't really know how to feel about this. But anyway, I do have 4MATIC all-wheel drive, which is fantastic. I also have a low-range transfer case and hill descent modes and all sorts of off-roady stuff. Air spring, optional air spring suspension for this GLE is going to give you a whole bunch of off-road confidence and things like that. This is very, very capable off-road, and Mercedes wants you to know that. That's why they put these grab handles here next to your trackpad for your infotainment. Now, in terms of engine, there are a couple options so far. I am in the GLE 350, which is the base engine. That is a turbocharged 2-liter four-cylinder, giving you 255 horsepower and 273 pound-feet of torque. If you're worried about the power difference because there are two less cylinders, don't fret at all, because that torque, that's the stuff that's going to make you feel peppy and strong around town. That is the same as the outgoing naturally aspirated V6. However, if you wanted to option up to the twin turbocharged straight six with EQ boost, that's electric boost, assist, whatever you want to call it. I won't go into the engineering and stuff behind that, but you are going to get 369 horsepower and 373 pound-feet of torque. Boom! That's some serious engine in something like this. So watch out, X5. I apologize, it's not actually 373 pound-feet, it's actually 369. But four off is not bad. And both engines will put that power through Mercedes' 9-speed automatic transmission that we've come to know and love oh so well. Now, I did want to talk about the suspension a little bit, and I did mention the 4MATIC all-wheel drive, and that's all well and good. That's not something we've not seen before, but this air suspension that I talked about is totally new. It gives you so much, I guess, practicality capability that you can go so far as to lift and lower a single wheel, depending on what terrain you're on, if you're rock crawling, if you're dune crawling. It's really amazing. Like, this air suspension, if you're ever going to go off-road, if you're ever going to, like, push this thing to its limits, I would totally get it. And it just makes the ride incredibly comfortable. It's very supple. It's very smooth. It's a fantastic ride, and it all comes together so incredibly well. Now, a turbocharged four-cylinder and a twin turbocharged straight six are fantastic, but you're probably wondering what's going to happen with the GLE 53 and the GLE 63. Those are not yet out. We do not have specs on those. However, I did know from Mercedes that they are going to be coming out at the end of the year here, so stay tuned if you're interested in something like a 53 or a 63. I have high hopes for that, especially with how peppy and aggressive the 450 is. So let's recap. We have a peppy engine, we have an opulently luxurious interior, we have an infotainment system on the bleeding edge of technology, we have an incredibly smooth and sorted suspension, and we have a rugged and durable chassis for off-road. I mean, there's not much more that you could want from this thing. All of these things working in tandem make this probably one of the best, if not definitely the best, SUVs in this segment. So if you're in the segment for a midsize SUV, absolutely come by and give this GLE a look. Now, I did want to show you guys one cool thing about this GLE. It has different themes. So you pick a theme and it actually defaults your infotainment and your gauge cluster into a certain look. You also default your driver setting. So right now I'm in the off-road setting, and I'm gonna show you what that looks like. So we have like a pitch and yaw sensor down here. We have what percentage of gas and brake we're using. We have our compass directional here. We also have pitch and yaw in the cluster, but we're just gonna go up and off-road right here real quick and hope that the park rangers don't see us and get mad at us. Yeah, there's no problem here. 4MATIC all-wheel drive, there's no issue whatsoever. And we'll climb back down. I mean, that was just a little prairie, but you guys, you know, kind of get it. And by prairie, I mean patch grass. Well, guys, as always, I hope you enjoyed this video. As always, hit that thumbs up, leave a comment, subscribe, patreon.com/downshiftmke, and I'll see you next time.